I would like to thank Dr. Bansi Sabu, sir, who has given me this opportunity and given me this task for presenting here in the prestigious Diacare Cone. And I would also like to thank him for giving me the award today for the Defeat Diabetes campaign. Thank you very much, sir. And my task has been made easy by Dr. Sanjay Agarwal, sir, and Dr. Sunil Gupta, sir, who has already talked about digital diabetes and what is the meaning of, what is, when we talk about the meaningful monitoring of the blood glucose. So I have been given a topic which is called comprehensive and connected diabetes care, and what a smartphone based glucometer can do. So as we know that the word comprehensive, we are talking again and again about the comprehensive care and the connected care, because comprehensive means we believe that many of the times some component of the diabetes care we are not able to implement. And one of the most common component which is not being implemented very well is the diabetes education, which we can do or give to our patient. But Dr. Sunil Gupta sir is doing it very extensively and very, very well. Connected, what is the mean of connected diabetes care? We know that most of the time our patients are not connected to us in between the visits. And if you look at your own practices and your own clinical experiences, you will find that an average diabetic patient may visit you twice a year, not more than that. So that is the frequency which we find. And even if he is visiting twice a year, I think he is still very much compliant. So in between these two visits or three visits, four visits, the patient has no connection with the medical team and there is total disconnection. So we want to talk about a care which is comprehensive, where diabetes education is not left out. And second component is the connected, where the patient is still connected to the doctor or the medical care team, even when they are not visiting regularly or if they are visiting the doctor after a long time. So I will be just talking about an overview of digital diabetology, but I will be skipping most of that part because Dr. Sanjay sir has already covered that. And we need to understand the paradigm shift which has happened in the digital diabetology over the last few years. And what is it, discuss the role of a glucometer, which is smartphone-based, and how it can help us in the monitoring and diabetes education. So in the era of digitalization and the connected care, if you can see that there is a huge increase in the number of people who are now using the internet, and it has grown almost 100,000 folds. So if you compare the data from since 1990 in 2021, you will find that there is a skyrocket increase in the number of people who are now using the internet on a daily basis. If you look at this slide, you will find that the use of internet, almost the total population of world is around 7.6 billion and unique mobile users are 5.1 billion users are still learning or using mobile, and 4.3 billion people are using internet almost on a daily basis, and there are more than 3.4 billion active social media users. So this is the power of the digital world. And now we have seen there are many companies which have launched a virtual world also where you can go and buy a digital space. If you look at the internet use and device perspective, you will find that almost 57% of the people, they are using internet, and total number of active mobile internet users are 3.98 billion. This is a huge number, and there is a marked increase in the number of people who are using internet connected devices. If you look at the digital data management to improve outcome in patient with type 2 diabetes, and if you look at this flow, you will try to understand that when a patient is there, then there is a collection of the data, which can happen through social media applications, glucometer sensors, wearables, electronic medical records, genetic, epigenetics, and metabolic state. This data is analyzed, individualized targets can be done, decision support system can be made, trends and alerts can be known, and there is a dedicated software which can review the data. This can actually connect, then when it is connected with the care team, it can improve the individualized care and lead to clinical patients. This is just a diagram just showing that how many things are available already and how many things will be available in the near future. Where a smart contact lens would be able to tell your glucose level, or a person may be wearing a flash or continuous glucose monitor, which is a reality. We know that smart ECG applications are already there. Smart blood pressure monitoring can happen, and smart drug, that is a precision drug, so the precision medicine is also the talk of the town. So it is the digital world which is growing and growing, and we have smart-based smart watches which can now sense your blood glucose levels. We are already in talks about the artificial pancreas, the socks which can check your temperature, inflammation, infection, and help in prevention of the amputation, and the weighing scales which are very smart and can tell you the body mass index and everything. So this is how the digital world is growing. And this is what a patient of type 1 or type 2 diabetes is placed. We are talking about diabetes prevention, diabetes care management, and diabetes research. So everything is connected digitally. And as rightly pointed out by Dr. Sanjay sir, that RSSDI alone is already in the process of developing a digital grid, which is going to help all of us in connecting and using this data for the patient welfare. Now I am going to talk about few things about the veto. The session is supported by the veto, and I would like to make a financial disclosure that I have not received any honorarium from the veto for this talk. The diabetes related applications are many. My Sugar app, we know that is a product of Roche. There are other applications like One Drop Diabetes Management and the Glucose. And just look at this, what veto is all about. So introduce you to the veto. It is thought of as a one-stop digital care ecosystem for diabetes management. You have a glucometer which can be connected to a smartphone, and whatever the data is collected by the glucometer is transmitted to the cloud. And you will find that there are multiple support systems which has been developed in the app. There are alerts which are given by the caregiver. Alerts are given, personalized nudging is there, conversation with the educator chatbot is there, addition support is there. It can be connected well with the wearable devices. There is a virtual doctor consult, curated content, and the medical referrals and insurance, and the curated e-commerce is also there. So this is a complete basket where a patient can find most of its things which can be used. Veto has already a high traction from the subscribers. So this slide, I would like to highlight that the use of this kind of app has grown ever since the COVID-19 pandemic has come. And a lot more and more people are trying to use the apps and the systems where they can be supported digitally for the video consultations, for the diabetes education, and for the monitoring of the data. So the use of such a glucometer, which is connected to the smartphone, is backed up by the data. And this is one of the study which was published in the Asian ACP-CON 2021, and reduction in hypoglycemia incidence using a veto connected diabetes care program. And this was a real world retrospective study where some of our friends like Dr. Mohit Sabharwal and Dr. Meenal was there. And the objective of the study was that they wanted that whether the digital diabetes management program aids the patient to improve their diabetes management and self-care, and whether the connected diabetes care program via smartphone connected glucometer makes any difference. And the objective was to assess the impact of veto connected diabetes care program on hypoglycemia incidence and factors associated with hypoglycemia incidence in India. And thus, the conclusion of the study was that it was found that the result demonstrated that veto connected diabetes care program was effective in reducing hypoglycemia incidence and diabetes patients in India. And this is the data chart. Time is short, I won't go into the details of the study. Another important thing is that another study that is outcome of an AI-enabled digital diabetes care ecosystem, where a smartphone-connected glucometer is coupled with a real-time feedback system. And this is a real-world study in the Indian setting. And other doctors are involved in the study. And again, this study found that the study SMBG and real-time engagement along with individualized care by a multidisciplinary team is effective in the reduction of hypoglycemia incidence and improving overall glycemic control. Again, another study which finds that such a ecosystem where the connected glucometer is used can be of use for our patients. So this is a slide which shows that this is a small glucometer, which can be connected directly to the smartphone. And you connect the strip to the glucometer, and it prompts you to take the reading. And when you touch the drop of the blood to the meter strip, the reading is automatically recorded by the app itself. And it is available there on the cloud for the future statistical analysis also. So we are, the conventional method is that we check from the glucometer. Most of the time we write it on the paper, and more often than not, we will not be making any record of that. We will simply try to remember the readings. But what happens is that our duration of time, we don't remember the readings at all, or whatever is written on the piece of paper goes off. What is the problem? Now we have glucometers which are Bluetooth connected, can be connected to the app. But again, you need to you need to pair your devices. Every time you need to switch on the device, switch on the Bluetooth so that the data is stored properly. But since it is directly connected, there is no chance that the data will always be stored in the app. So there is no chance of missing any of the reading, because otherwise the reading will not come unless or until it is connected to a smartphone device. Not only does allows you to record your sugar digitally, but also allows it auto saves the reading. On demand doctor consultation can be done on this platform. Personalization, food and fitness tools are there, and there are other e-commerce things are also available, which may be useful for some of the patients. So a typical patient journey in the system is that a blood glucose reminder is there. Patient takes the blood glucose reading. Reading is normal. Then the patient gets the message, the great job. And the stock up on diabetes is essential to help maintain your blood glucose levels. If the patient is not having glucose readings which are not on target, there is an alert which goes to the doctor. And the patient gets personalized messages to motivate to be more compliant with the diet, exercise, as well as the medicine. And patient is given curated educational content and get diabetes essentials. If the patient is reading is out of range repeatedly, consecutive times, then the patient can be offered a customized plan as recommended by the doctor. Or if we get more readings which are out of the box, then the patient automatically gets connected with a diabetes educator. So that is very important. And not only this, the patient can set in the alarms for the to refill their medication packs and all. So this is very important. So it is important to understand that digital technology is going to be a key connection, and it is going to connect the patient to the doctors in between the visits. And that digital health is the future of the diabetes. So there are mobile applications, internet portals, websites, and there are thousands of studies which have proven that it can improve diabetes care in some way or the other. It can help us in better glucose control, improved SMBG frequencies, better patient satisfaction, better weight management, better medication adherence. There can be barriers to the use digital tool for the diabetes management are as post. Sometime you may not be technology savvy or technology friendly, and people may doubt the insufficient scientific evidence, but more as we use them more and more data is coming, and we can actually talk about the data and the studies. Despite there are many challenges to overcome these, the future of the digital health industry does seem to look promising. And many of these devices are now approved by the FDA, and there are guidelines which are given by the FDA for an app as well as the health software developers. And these are the medical device data systems. So they are classified in three classes, class three being high risk to class one being low risk. And this is based on the potential risk of using the software or digital tool. And the European Union has also issued a regulatory framework for mHealth. So it is important to understand the regulatory guidelines also. So digital diabetology should be viewed as adjunct to diabetes mellitus care. We need to have a proper use of technology which can improve the quality of digital diabetology can actually lead to improving the quality of care and clinical outcomes in management of type 2 diabetes patients. So the key takeaway messages are that technology can help in improving diabetes care, bringing together the sensor devices, data analytics, and the patient reported information. Digital and mobile-based technology may be considered a useful aid to standard management of the diabetes and other chronic health disorders. And studies have shown that digital tool can help in lowering HbA1c, fasting plasma glucose, or the postprandial glucose, and reduction in the hypoglycemia events. So with this, I would like to thank you.